Link in the description will show you all the statistics so far in this season. Maybe you can use it to find some other cool stat stuff. Luigi here, Item Feud Season 2, Episode 5.2. Today I'm gonna figure out the best way to impersonate someone. But of course, we have to look at the item usage. Did I throw you guys off by switching it around? Well, Angel used their lucky clover, and they chose to get a love filter instead of a book. Kyle used Skew Yourself on Brayden, so their percentile will be skewed to Brayden's. Their score will be 90% theirs and 10% Brayden's. Lady Molab used Flower on the purple team, and the random contestant to get a 5% boost on their team is... Lady Molab! How fortunate for them, they get a 5% boost. Lastly, the name you see on the screen used Snowball Catapult on Amazing Pikachu, so not only do they lose 1%, but their Shmoo Bomb and No New Items pensive item turn into snowballs! Oh no! And now we look at fan art. Maxfecto shows us who the real Chads are. Purple team is owning green and orange team. Azim also gave us an accurate representation of the teams right now. JMO showed us Item Feud Season 2 Episode 5 going against Sand Season 2 Episode 0. Grondo shows us the true identity of the green team. They're actually Dream apparently. The Mighty Chicken drew a purple team being Thanos next to the orange and green team fighting. JMO drew themselves questioning Grondo's fan art. Single Devlo drew an amazing drawing featuring orange team and a money bag of people who are going to non-live this round. It's really creative and cool. Maxfecto drew this video of his new Game Boy Advance game. Let's see it.
Hello, welcome to Item Feud episode 11.2. I'm Little Luigi. Check out this cool layout thing. Two people sent me confessionals this round. War Bunny and Change on Brayden were absolute losers and got tomato juice all over them.
Very interesting. You know, I'd pay $3 a month for that. And now for results. The contestant who answered the prompt. You've been caught committing a terrible crime, so now you need to take someone's identity. And what clever way do you take someone's place in life without people they're close to noticing? The best was... Lady Molab! Someone who hasn't gotten first yet. They submitted, immediately run for political office. Your confidence will instill the need to act like a completely different person while on the campaign trail. Very interesting, I'll keep this tactic in mind. Their flower boost didn't change the fact that they got first. Congrats Molab, you win a prize. In second place we have... Koopa, who's decided to stay in second place for another round. Good consistency. And third is... Chalkin, whose submission I enjoy. I'll consider it for later in life when I'm pranking people. And fourth is... Monica, who wants to impersonate some famous people. Good luck with that. And finally, the non-prizer in the yellow zone is... JMO, who is kind of a bizarre way to hide their identity, but it seems to work. And now time for the kinda yellow zone. In here we have War Bunny, Angel, Ice Cream, Based, and Brayden. Despite War Bunny's submission being minimal, it still manages to get the voters' attention. Brayden is disguising as someone else by pretending to disguise as someone else. Now, in the boring gray zone is Omelette, Masaruk, Lees, Kyle, Max, and Akenik. Looks like Kyle's Skew Yourself didn't do much. Their submission is also most likely not going to actually happen. And the kind of red zone is... Tanker, Brizzlebrip, Yoshi Awesome, Squish, and Super Rainbows. Ew, Brizzlebrip has got disgusting red juice all over him. This is not okay. Also, Yoshi's submission was the most controversial one we've had this round. Lastly, the people in the red zone are... Pikachu, Chicken, Percy, Devlo, and Azim. Percy's submission was the least controversial one we had. Ugh, and Devlo 2, they also have disgusting looking stuff on them. Well, it's time for the score reveal. Let's see which team will lose a life. Go! It looks like Team lost their last life, which means that 80% of their team is going bye-bye and we're all gonna be switching teams. Hold on to your pants, we're gonna take a look at the orange team's scores. In case you forgot, the contestants that left the game show count as a fraction of a contestant based on the amount of rounds they participated in. I'm gonna reveal the orange team's scores from best to worst. 6 Orange Team members will be eliminated, and 2 Orange Team members will survive. Let's start. The first Orange contestant to survive is... Slave Disdain, wait a second, that's a dead contestant. A dead contestant did better than the people who were alive. Oh, whatever. The actual first Orange contestant to be safe is... Angel! They are safe with a score of 61.32%. Good work staying alive. And the only other Orange contestant that is safe from elimination is the contestant Amazing Pikachu. Their average score was 58.95%. Congrats. And I'm so sorry, Monica, Omelette, Masrock 9, Kyle Does Everything, Squish, and Azeem, but your teamwork could only do so much. You are all eliminated from Item Fee Season 2, but don't give up hope yet. There's still things you can do after your death. Now, it's time for the green team elimination. Half their team will be eliminated, 4 of them will survive, and 3 of their contestants will be eliminated. The first green team contestant to be safe from elimination is... Chain Chomp Brayden with a score of 69.12%. Nice job surviving. The next green team contestant to be safe is... Nikaunik with a score of 61.47%. Good work staying in the top half. The third green contestant that is safe from elimination is... Koopa 472, a complete newcomer to Item Feud. Good work showing off your skills, Koopa. And the last contestant on the green team to survive is the contestant Chalkin, who was 0.5% away from being eliminated. Good job surviving, but I'm sorry that Warbunny, Brizzlebrip, and Single Devilo have to be eliminated. Unfortunately, the teamwork in the green team wasn't enough to propel you guys, but you guys can still make great submissions in the future. There goes 9 contestants, and also the 11 that were eliminated from not participating. So, what could the dead contestants do? First of all, they can make their own items right now! I have to approve it, of course, though. You will all be able to send Spaghetti Luigi an item idea that will be added to the game. You can also give a description of the icon and the name for the item, too. I might have to tweak it or not approve it if I feel like it doesn't fit Item Feud. Be creative, because this is your only chance to make an item. The other things you can do is send a eulogy to Spaghetti Luigi. I will show off these last words in the next episodes to commemorate you. And lastly, you will be able to submit ghost submissions in later rounds that don't count towards anything, so be excited for that. Oh, I guess I have to split you guys into new teams now. Ugh, fine. The new team colors are... Eton Blue! Check it out. The next one is... Blue Yonder! And the last one is... Maximum Red Purple! On the Eton Blue team is... Angel, Chain Chomp Brayden, Chalkin, J-Mo, Nikaunik, and Tanker. Good luck, guys. On the Blue Yonder team is... Maxfecto, Percy, Lee's 123321, The Mighty Chicken, and Base Shotgun. There's only 5 of you, but I have faith in you guys. Lastly, in the Maximum Red Purple team is... Lady Molub, Koopa 472, Amazing Pikachu 37, Yoshi Awesome, Super Rainbows, and Ice Cream. I hope you guys can work well together. Don't forget to come up with a new team name and icon. It's time for the new era of teams. Okay, back to reality. The only cool stats I have for you guys today is that Angel has taken over Percy in the popularity contest by a sudden spike in mentions. I wonder how Angel could have gotten so many mentions in such a short amount of time, but somehow they did it. The prompt for round 6 is... Oh no, choose a dead or alive contestant has gone missing! What will for sure get them to come out of hiding and rush back? Here's an example submission. All I need to learn Mario is my stash of gold coins. There's no way he can resist. Answer this prompt by March 21st, 4 PM CST. Also come up with a team name and icon by then. Comment down which team is your favorite so far. Like, subscribe, bye! Thanks, the Mighty Chicken, Maxfecto, Omelette, Josh, Brizzlebrip, and Percy for supporting me on Patreon.